It's martini time.
Hi, welcome to a special episode of Tannic Grips. We are without Miss Jill Mott today, but that's okay because we have Michael Torsch here, and we are going to kind of take things in a different direction. Michael, tell everybody what we're doing today.
Today we're going to be talking about a certain publication that you can find right here at Henry & Son. It's called the Cocktail Codex.
We don't have our fancy camera, so we're going to zoom.
This is a publication from the same folks that brought you Death & Co. We have a lot of signed copies here, so we're just going to go through why this is kind of a cool book.
Yeah. Well, to begin with, it's Nick Foschold is one of the writers, and he is local to Minnesota, and he lives here now, and he's really amazing. He also, again, wrote the Death & Co. cookbook, well, it is a cookbook, I mean, but cocktail book, and so he was able to come in and sign several of these copies, so that's why we have a signed copy. It also won the James Beard Award in 2019 for Best Cookbook, which is pretty unprecedented for not Best Cocktail Book, not Best, like, Spirits Book or anything, specifically a cookbook, so that's pretty cool. Mm-hmm. But I was pretty excited about this as a professional bartender. I find it to be an exciting and engaging cocktail recipe book that brings me back to the basics, but it also kind of invites me to choose my own adventure and explore other options. But I think what I really like to hear is what Michael has to say, because he's not bartended professionally.
So. Not at all. And so I'm a very casual drinker when it comes to cocktails.
He's not casual. The rest is for it.
Yeah, and I get a little intimidated when I'm talking to, you know, bartender and mixologist professionals about kind of articulating what I want or what I'm looking for. Mm-hmm. And even at home, like if I want to make a cocktail, I don't really know even where to go. And the cookbooks that I do, the cookbooks, we can call them.
Yeah, I like that.
The cookbooks that I do have, it's always like, oh, you want to have, like, you know, this gin from like this country, from like mm-hmm. this spot, and like these very obscure bitters. And so when approaching this book, it kind of, like a choose your own adventure kind of
it is.
Fair way of putting it, yeah.
But it starts with six basic cocktails. And just to reference back, the six basic cocktails are an old fashioned. There are only six cocktails.
The old fashioned,
right.
The martini, the daiquiri, the sidecar, the whiskey highball, and the flip.
And so, to read directly from the book, once you understand the hows and whys of each recipe, you'll understand why some cocktails work while others don't, and how to make ingredient substitutions and variations on the classics, why you like the drinks you do, and how to invent entirely new cocktails. So that's kind of what this book posits at the beginning, and I have to say that I find it to be pretty accurate, mm-hmm. and it's just like a really, really great, again, like you could have been in the industry for a really long time. You could have been making drinks. You could just be a like very engaged at-home person. But bringing it back to like the drinks that you love and simplifying them, like it adds excitement and nuance in a way that's really unexpected. And so for that reason, the book is kind of broken down with those six recipes guiding even more recipes, as well as a couple little notes on specific liquors and kind of why they start with the basic recipe. Mm-hmm. They start with their ideal recipe. And they kind of give you the reason why. They're not trying to pontificate and be like, this is like, you know, this is the only way to do it. It's saying, hey, this is why we like this recipe the best. Like, this is why we like this spirit the best. And so what I think is just super fun, we just decided that we would start with a basic recipe and a riff on the recipe kind of like as they're kind of doing in the book. So I'm using the daiquiri recipe. And the classic recipe calls for 2 ounces of rum, 3/4 of fresh lime juice, and 3/4 of simple syrup. They kind of expand on what kind of simple syrup you want and what kind of ratio. I'm doing a 2-to-1 simple syrup. That means 2 parts sugar to 1 part water. You can take that. I think that breaking things down into ratios is the simplest way to kind of make syrups because, again, you can if you're measuring it by grams, you can measure it by volume, cups versus grams, et cetera, et cetera. So that's what we're going to do today, but we're going to do a fun little spin on it, and we're going to do, because it's fall, and let's face it, it snowed a lot yesterday, so aquavit. So stick that bottle of aquavit in the snow, and while you're at it, you know, after drinking pulls of it to just kind of get through these long months that are ahead of us, we are going to make little kind of aquavit daiquiris with it, using preserved preserved and fermented limes from Topos Ferments, which we will be carrying in the shop. These are also awesome in salads as well as in a chicken tinga recipe, which I found out the other day.
Delicious.
So, cool. I don't know, anything else you want to say on the book?
Yeah, I mean, you kind of talked about this briefly, is, you know, it gives you the basic recipe and it talks about, oh, you might want to use this type of rum. And so when it talks about that, it goes through like Spanish-style rum, English-style rum, French-style rum, Jamaican-style rum, and that, not to say that it exclusively talks about rum throughout the book, but for this chapter at least.
Yeah.
And then goes through recommended bottles. And it's about a few paragraphs of each, and so it gives you kind of a basic understanding of the differences between these different liqueurs. And I think that is a nice way to just kind of like get your way into just like one thing at a time and learn more about the world of cocktails. So. Oh yeah, so we're talking about, I didn't even know about all these different types of rum. A French style rum, delicious. Jamaican style rum, we've heard of that before. It was just a great treat. And our Spanish style rum, which I have not really read too much about. And so I have a few paragraphs here just to get a little introductory course on what Spanish style rum is. I can't wait to educate myself with this book a little bit more. And we're already done?
Doesn't take that long when you've pre-measured all the ingredients.
Fantastic.
A little
fantastic.
Bit of TV magic.
But we're using aquavit here, so we're a little different. We're outside
right.
of the rum.
So I had measured everything out, but what I did was 2 ounces of spirit, as per the daiquiri recipe, where it called for 2 ounces of rum. I did 2 ounces of aquavit. And then I did 3/4 of a simple syrup. And then I did 3/4 of fresh lime juice. I added a little bit of this lime juice that's actually kind of in the, like it's actually in the preserved limes. I added a little bit of that to maybe like 1/8 ounce to it because it actually has quite a bit of salinity to it. And then I chopped up about 1/2 ounce of one lime with the peel and everything. And I shook it with everything in there. Another way to do this, which I have done in the past with fermented limes, you can blend it with sugar and kind of add to it and add some water and create a syrup and strain it. That's a really simple way to do something with preserved limes. Preserved limes are a little bit more floral than a preserved lemon, but still kind of can be used interchangeably in my opinion. I think that this is a really fun, I think the fermented limes in this case really complement the savoriness of aquavit, which has a lot of caraway notes if you're not familiar with it. It's a neutral grain spirit, not unlike gin, and it's been infused with various botanicals, but primarily caraway is going to be the one takeaway note. So, anyways, I don't know. Cheers.
Cheers.
Salute to 2020.
2020. Best year of my life.
So, it's like got a lot of like unctuous flavors is like the word that comes to mind for myself.
Totally.
Like there's that preserved note that is just like, it's a little salty without being salty. And salt in cocktails is incredibly important. And it's just as important as sugar as anything else in my opinion. So it's super fun. Again, this is like a wonderful wintry sour. So I highly recommend it. And you can purchase this Cocktail Codex book. Again, like, so fun, such an, like, choose your own adventure. It's really great. I don't know. I mean, I think, like, I'm pretty familiar with this book, so I kind of like letting Michael talk a little bit more about it because he's a little newer to it.
Yeah, and as I've explored this, I really have to say, if there is a cocktail book to own, this might be it. I have the Death & Co. book, and
yeah.
I flipped through that, and it's nice, but I do feel a little intimidated approaching some of those recipes and approaching some of these. But this lays it out in very simple terms. I don't feel intimidated. And there's absolutely zero pretension here at all. I feel like I'm just talking to a friend when I'm reading this book and learning more about what goes into these 6 classic cocktails and how you can go and choose your own adventure and explore
them. It's like what I liked about school. Like,
that's
when you
book.
Actually
yeah.
learned things,
totally.
But nobody was like shoving it down your throat and acting like you were
totally.
An idiot if you didn't get something. Like, there's an answer for everything in this book, and it's just an incredibly accessible book. And by breaking it down with the 6 basic cocktails, I think you really like get to realize like, how often are we learning like simple's better? Like minimalist is kind of a movement, and that's not at all what we're trying to like, you know, promote here. Mm-hmm. I like clutter. That's why I work in a bottle shop. But anyways, I think that at the end of the day, getting down to the basics, especially with recipes and like kind of cutting away the fat,
totally,
as it were, is a really important thing to do, because that's how you can learn how to like add in and actually appropriately season your drink.
Sure.
Like, really, like, I don't know, it can be kind of intimidating. I think this book is really accessible for
absolutely
all different levels.
Absolutely. And you can just, and I like learning, even this like page right here is like about shaking and like, oh, shaking with one large ice cube versus shaking with 1-inch cubes. Would have never thought about that distinction, but
and
now
we
I
do
am.
We do actually sell the large ice cubes.
We do sell the large ice cubes, and they're great. Mm-hmm. I never know how to use them, but now I could.
I mean, also you can take a deli cup and like freeze it, and then you take a screwdriver and very carefully, or an ice pick, but you know.
It's a great tip. Try at your own risk, it sounds like.
Maybe get an ice pick. Actually, it's a little bit safer than an actual screwdriver.
Sure. But yeah, I do feel like I could take this book home and look at my, you know, somewhat modest liquor shelf and put together some cool cocktails, you know, based off these recommendations in here. It's a great little exploration of a new way to drink.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Yeah.
It's martini time.